Hey everybody, it's I, Retro Matt, also known as Victory Roll 84 on the Filsimer Games forums. And this is the GWF Years 2087. And the Galactic Wrestling Federation was formed in the tail end of the 21st century when space travel became a common thing and colonization linked the cosmos together. Omega of Cetus organized and founded the GWF, becoming its first champion. And in those early years, there was no face or heels, but all the wrestlers were pretty well just vying for the GWF Heavyweight Championship belt. However, that all changed when Thanos broke the Galactic Code and formed his own supergroup called the Evil Ones to rule the Federation. However, Star Warrior, the most popular hero in the Federation, formed his own group called the FDF to take out Thanos and his evil cronies. So the cosmic struggle began as the GWF would have to prove its explosive appeal to millions across the galaxy. And here's an in-depth look. Thanos, the evil game master, leader of the villain group, Thanos brought in Exo King and the Evil Ones to help out his cause to thwart the heroes. Things turned south when he tried to recruit the gladiators of Athra, namely Wolf, who left the camp to side with the heroes. Thanos' bouts involving Star Warrior are classics all around the arenas in the galaxy. Star Warrior, the leader of the heroes of the FDF, the son of Omega. The son of Omega has immense pressure to end Thanos' corrupt and evil ways, coupling the fact that a short few years prior, the two were one of the greatest tag teams in the history of the GWF, now seems like a distant memory. The Evil Ones, this subset of wickedness is led by the giant killer Exo King, as he tangles with the FDF's giant wrestler known as Massive. GWF officials, in some cosmic wrestling mags, have stated the illegal use of robotic parts by the Evil Ones in their matches, given to them by their supreme leader Thanos. The Battle of the Giants is a main event anywhere, but who will come out on top? Killer Queen and Death Knight round out the sadistic group. The FDF, led by Star Warrior, and consisting of the giant Massive, the legend himself, Omega, the patriotic Commander Sam, these four GWF heroes look to put an end to the evil ways of Thanos, Comrade Terran, and all the other villainous snakes inside the Federation. Loner and rebel of the GWF Wolf has reluctantly joined up with the heroes as he's made a friend in Proteus of the Greek gods. Thanos has sent the executioner after Wolf. The gladiators are none too happy with Wolf either and seek revenge as well on him. The Flying Titans, led by Lord Nexus. These heroes from Saturn are locked in a blood feud with the Society of Death and its leader, the Invincible Kraken. Pit Viper was scarred by Kraken and his cronies, namely Khan and Mutant, and Pulsar is the youngest wrestler in the Federation. The Society of Death, its leader Kraken, is a busy man, with Pit Viper brutally assaulted, even wants to take over the leadership of Thanos' villain team. Kraken is a force to reckon with his henchmen, by his side, Mutant and Genghis Khan. Greek gods, the time travelers from Earth's past, and original wrestlers, Actagon and Proteus, are the tag team champions defending their belts versus the violent gladiators, Brute and Massacre. The gladiators. Brute and Massacre don't trust anyone in the GWF. Not even Thanos could sway them to the villain's side. Don't worry, they're still very villainous. They wage war against anyone, but mainly Wolf, the Greek gods, Neptunian spacecroppers. Beast Rider and Renegade are looking for payback versus Vanity, who left their team high and dry a year before. Vanity has teamed with Killer Queen, and teams are at each other's throats. Next time, 2088 brings us a firestorm of controversy as Bishop Hell enters the GWF. Will the Federation burn to the ground, or will someone stand up to his controversial Hellfire finisher?